Oh no! SpaceX's Falcon 9 suffers upper stage engine failure during yesterday's Starlink launch. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. Hello everyone. Hope you all are doing well. Today's episode brings some unfortunate news for all the Falcon 9 fans out there. I know our community is filled with enthusiasts of both Falcon 9 and Starship, as Falcon 9 has been the backbone of SpaceX's operations for many years and continues to be so. So, what exactly went wrong during the recent Starlink launch and deployment? Let's discuss. Yesterday, July 11th, a malfunction in the upper stage engine of a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket disrupted a mission carrying a batch of Starlink satellites, potentially causing significant repercussions across the space industry. The Falcon 9 launched from Vandenberg Space Force Base in California at 10:35 p.m. Eastern, aiming to deliver 20 Starlink satellites into orbit, including 13 equipped with direct-to-cell payloads. The mission, designated Group 9 to 3 by SpaceX, initially appeared to progress as planned. The rocket's ascent to orbit was typical, with the first stage successfully landing on a droneship. However, during the first burn of the second stage, observers noticed an unusual accumulation of ice around the cover of the Merlin engine. This anomaly, not usually observed in Falcon 9 launches, did not seem to impair the stage's immediate performance. The mission plan included a 1 second engine burn 52 minutes and 20 seconds after liftoff to circularize the orbit, followed by the deployment of the Starlink satellites. By the time SpaceX ended its launch webcast, there was no immediate confirmation of these milestones. Hours later, Elon Musk, CEO of SpaceX, took to social media to address the situation. He stated, "Upper stage restart to raise perigee resulted in an engine RUD for reasons currently unknown." In SpaceX terminology, RUD stands for Rapid Unscheduled Disassembly, essentially meaning an anomaly. Musk further explained that while the Starlink satellites were deployed, their perigee might be too low for them to maintain orbit. He indicated that more information would be available in the following hours. Jonathan McDowell, an astronomer and spaceflight expert, estimated that the launch had placed the upper stage on an initial transfer orbit of 138 by 295 kilometers before the second crucial circularization burn. The timing of the engine anomaly during this brief burn would be critical in determining whether the satellites could avoid an immediate re-entry. After almost an hour, SpaceX posted on X, "During tonight's Falcon 9 launch of Starlink, the second stage engine did not complete its second burn. As a result, the Starlink satellites were deployed into a lower than intended orbit. SpaceX has made contact with 5 of the satellites so far and is attempting to have them raise orbit using their ion thrusters." Elon Musk also provided a further explanation. "We're updating satellite software to run the ion thrusters at their equivalent of Warp 9. Unlike a Star Trek episode, this will probably not work, but it's worth a shot. The satellite thrusters need to raise orbit faster than atmospheric drag pulls them down, or they burn up." Just a quick update. Make sure you are subscribed to our community. Recently, many new members have joined our spaceflight community, and we're excited to welcome them. I don't want any of you to miss out on the latest SpaceX and space updates. So, back to our topic, you know, this incident marks the first failure, whether partial or total, for a Falcon 9 rocket since September 2016. That previous incident involved a pad explosion during a pre-flight test, which destroyed the rocket and its communications satellite payload. The last in-flight failure of a Falcon 9 occurred in June 2015, when the upper stage broke apart during the launch of a cargo Dragon spacecraft. Since then, the Falcon 9 has maintained an impressive record of success. This launch was the 354th for a Falcon 9, with the June 2015 in-flight failure occurring on the 19th Falcon 9 launch. Additionally, there have been 10 Falcon Heavy launches, all of which have been successful. As you all know, the global space industry's reliance on the Falcon 9 for space access has grown significantly due to its high flight rate and the developmental challenges faced by new launch vehicles. Various countries and companies, including those competing with SpaceX's Starlink constellation and European government organizations, have turned to the Falcon 9 for launching spacecraft. This widespread reliance underscores the broader implications of the recent anomaly. The malfunction also raises concerns for human spaceflight missions. The Falcon 9 was scheduled to launch a Crew Dragon spacecraft at the end of July for the Polaris Dawn private astronaut mission, followed in mid-August by the Crew 9 mission. The latter aims to deliver 4 astronauts to the International Space Station, ISS, for a 6-month stay. NASA has been heavily reliant on SpaceX for ISS access due to delays and issues in the development of Boeing's CST-100 Starliner spacecraft. This recent incident with the Falcon 9 upper stage engine could have far-reaching consequences. The Falcon 9's high success rate has made it a cornerstone for many space endeavors, from deploying satellite constellations to ferrying astronauts and cargo to the ISS. The reliability of this rocket has been a significant factor in its widespread adoption. As SpaceX looks towards this setback, the focus will be on understanding the cause of the anomaly and implementing measures to prevent future occurrences. In the immediate aftermath, SpaceX will likely conduct a thorough investigation to pinpoint the exact cause of the engine malfunction. This process will involve analyzing telemetry data, inspecting recovered hardware, and possibly conducting additional ground tests. The goal will be to identify any underlying issues that could have led to the ice buildup and subsequent engine failure. For the Starlink satellites that were deployed, the next few hours and days will be critical. SpaceX will be monitoring their orbits closely to determine if they can achieve the necessary altitude to avoid re-entry. The Starlink constellation is a vital part of SpaceX's long-term strategy to provide global internet coverage, and any loss of satellites could impact this ambitious project. Moreover, this incident highlights the inherent risks of spaceflight. Even with advanced technology and rigorous testing, the complexity of launching and operating rockets means that anomalies can and do occur. For companies and organizations planning missions, this serves as a reminder of the importance of redundancy and contingency planning. As SpaceX addresses this recent failure, the company's track record suggests that it will take swift and effective action. SpaceX has demonstrated resilience in the face of past setbacks, using each as an opportunity to improve and advance its technology. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.